Hi friends, it's Terry Gaines. In this video, I'm going to share a fun way to package up your Halloween candy into these cute treat holders. Before I show you how to make the treat holder, I'm going to talk about the product I used to create my samples. I used designer series paper called Them Bones. It's 12 by 12 in size. You get two each of the six double-sided prints. I used this print for the background on that sample. This designer series paper coordinates with a bundle called Bag of Bones. You get the stamp set and the dies. The dies will cut out all of these images in the stamp set. You get some additional sentiments in the stamp set. Plus you get all of these dies that you can cut out. I actually use the dies here to cut out the designer series paper for this sample. So what I want to share with you is the paper's 12 by 12 in size. On the back side of my paper, I put some of the adhesive sheets that Stampin' Up! sells. There's 12 in a package and they're 6 by 12. So on the back side of my designer series paper, what I did is I peeled the backings off of my adhesive sheet and I put it on the back of my designer series paper. And I actually put two of them because the paper's 12 by 12 and the adhesive sheet is 6 by 12. Once I got that on, I cut it up with a scissors so I had my paper wide enough to go on the platform of my die cutting machine. And then I was able to use the dies to cut out the skeletons. You can use the dies to cut out the cat and the dog. And then what you can also do with the remaining pieces of your paper here, you can see by this sample, I cut out bats, I cut out just some black cats, I cut out the boo that's on some of these, I cut out the bats, the dies. So I'm utilizing all of my extra paper here for any image that I need something black. I did the cowboy boots, I did the hats. So what's nice about that is when you cut that out and you peel the back of this off and it's like a sticker. So you can utilize your designer series paper for the remaining part of your designer series paper for any project that you need black paper and adhesive sheet on the back. So that's a tip I wanted to share with you. Some of my samples also are using a bundle that's called Tricks and Treats. And for this bundle, you have some images that can be cut out with the dies. You have some additional sentiments, some other images, plus dies. So you get the stamp set and the dies are bundled together for 10% savings, or you can get them separate. The dies, along with coordinating with the stamp set, you have some additional dies. This die image here, when you take two of those, you can create a little tote bag. And then there's a couple different dies, depending if you have a thinner ribbon or cording or wider, that you can create the holes. And then you can even put a decorative top on that. I use the dies to create the candy corn. There's three of these. So I used three different colors and created candy corn for some of my samples. I also want to share with you a tip. This is actually two stamp images here. I find it best to put the detail part on first, so stamp that. I use the black ink for that, and then stamp the bold image over that. I can get my alignment better for that. This boo die is also one of the dies that I use with the adhesive sheet. I use that die and I cut out somewhere in here. You can see some different images here, and that worked perfect for having adhesive on the back. So I use this die set for some of my, that bundle for some of my samples. I do have a sample here that I used Pick of the Patch bundle. It's got a punch and the stamp set. And then I also use the Happy Halloween for a lot of my samples from this stamp set. So I found that was a very versatile stamp set to use. I also have another sample here that I used a folder. This folder is called Leaf Fall 3D Folder. It is part of the online exclusive products. And what I did is I texturized this portion of the cardstock before I assembled it. The stopper I use for this sample is from the Autumn Leaves bundle. I use this dye here. So in this sample, I have very vanilla and I have some chocolates in here. This is a gold foil leaf. And then this is a rose gold leaf. My videos have bloopers, misspoken words. Sometimes I catch them, sometimes I don't. So I do apologize for that. If you found me via YouTube, in the text portion of the video, there'll be a direct link to my blog post where you can download a PDF that's going to give you all the measurements to create this treat holder. And it's going to give you a link to this video that you can save this file and then click on the link and come back to the video to rewatch it next time you want to make some. So in this, on the PDF, I tell you that the treat holder is created with a piece of cardstock that is 11 inches by 3 inches. That's to create one. If you're going to create more than one, I would cut your cardstock to be 11 by 6. And I did that ahead of time. I took my 8.5 by 11 cardstock and I cut it to be 6 by 11. Now we want to score this. You can use your trimmer with a scoring blade. I'm going to actually use the Simply Scoring. I love using the Simply Scoring, so I'm going to use that. And it's easier to demonstrate on a video, I think, to explain how all of this works. So what I'm going to do along the 11-inch side is score at these different markings. So the first one is at 1 1/4. Then it's at 2 inches. Then it's at 3 3/4 inches. Then it's at 4 1/2, 7 3/4, and then 8 1/2. So I'm gonna score that cardstock, and we don't need the Simply Scoring any longer, so I'm gonna move that out of the way and grab my paper trimmer. Now I'm going to bring this in and cut it to be the 3 by 11 size. So now I can cut this. And now I have scored two of them at the same time, which does save time. So now we're going to reference this graphics I created to help with the assembly. So what I'm going to do is you want to make sure you have it in the same direction as you look at this. And I have drawn what is to represent a heartfelt hexagon punch. This is a punch that Stampin' Up! Has available. And it's a new release, or I'm sorry, an early release for World Card Making Day. World Card Making Day is Saturday, October 7th. And I have the code number for the punch on the bottom of the text for the video. I have all the links to the product along with on my blog post if you'd like to purchase the punch. So with this punch, what we're going to do is bring it in on this end, let it rest all the way down to the end, so it's resting all the way down, and then center it so it's equal on both sides here, and punch out this image. And now we have that punched out. Now what we want to do is fold these score lines. I have a indication here that V is for a valley fold and M is for a mountain fold. So at each one of these score lines, I have indicated how you're going to fold that. So we're going to start out with a valley fold, and that's fold in like so. And then all the rest of them are mountain folds. So we're gonna fold all of those to be mountain folds. What that's going to do is create your holder. It's kind of like a box almost. It's gonna create it like this. I do have an indication here that where the adhesive is. So if we put this back down to represent the valley and all the mountain folds, I have a note here that the adhesive is here, but it's on the other side, meaning we're going to flip this over and put the adhesive on this back side. I'm going to use Seal Plus. You can use almost any adhesive. The Seal Plus is stronger than Seal, not as strong as Tear and Tape, but I think any double stick adhesive will work. So on the third fold or score line, so we have 1, 2, 3. At the third score line, you're going to fold this and lay this flat, and that's going to adhere that portion to your cardstock. And then you can place your candies right in here, and it's big enough to place lots of different options. I don't think I shared that I have candy corn in this one, and I have on this one, I have trail mix. Now, I do want to share another tip. If you're going to package up your candies, what you can do is tie your ribbon onto a twist tie and put the twist tie around your treats. That way you can untie or unpackage it without undoing the bow. And so back to our project, got distracted there. So what we need to do to finish this is you would decorate this portion of your treat holder. And then you need a stopper. Most of my stoppers, I use the double oval punch. This one, I use the little leaf punches. This, I use dies, but you can use any type of image that's going to be your stopper. So what we're going to then do is fold this or hold it so you got this square. You're going to take two dimensionals and you're going to place them on the holder. I'll place them, then I'll kind of explain. So you're going to place them on this surface, right underneath where this cover closes like that. So you're going to form it like that, take your backings off, and then you put a stopper here. So I'm going to put this down so I can work with it. So my stopper is an oval, and I'm going to place this down. I wanted to catch this top, so this top has a place where to just rest and close. So that is how simple these treat holders are. I have made these before with different punches. I will reference on my blog post, my previous blog post, where I show the very same treat holder made with different punches and different decorations from years in the past. I hope you enjoy this project and have fun creating some of these fun treat holders. If you have any questions, please reach out to me. I would love to have you subscribe to my YouTube channel. And thank you, and take care, and happy creating.